Hello, Robert.
Up there to the
Vice President, how are you doing?
How are you?
Good to see you.
All right, sir. How are you, sir?
Yes, you're right over here.
Would you have my answer? Did he warn you about the
phone? Put Simpson right here when he
What do you want me?
You're right.
No, you're going to sit right there.
He's got me on Simpson.
Then I'm sitting in here.
He's got me on Well, two of the little pills in the morning and three at night. They're getting better.
What's that?
Niacin.
Niacin.
The ear thing.
And the, makes the you hear better. It opens up the. I was out in California. I saw went to see his hearing doctor. Dr. House.
It's kind of itchy.
Strauss recommended him. I have a little hearing problem with this right here.
See, we have small talk here two ways, photographers and then some of the writers.
Easy for us on the Senate side. He says start off with 50
million. Well, I just checked over the
You know, it sort of makes you feel flush. It sort of opens up the little vein. That helps on the ear, apparently. He gave me yesterday. I've got a little hearing problem.
That's it.
He takes them all the time.
Yeah. Well, he takes a lot more than 50 milligrams.
Yeah, he may. Well, you can take more. If it doesn't work, then you're supposed to get up to not more than four pills.
Yeah.
This is Simpson right here.
That's Simpson.
Yeah.
We get an invisible Simpson.
Oh, you got B.O. there.
That's got a wicked disease.
Mr. President, how could so much be going on inside your White House without you knowing about it, sir?
I don't know that was going on inside my White House.
Mr. President, as a result
of several thousand miles away.
As a result of the testimony by Colonel North, you plan to ask for a much larger fund to aid the Contras this year, and do you think the prospects are better?
I know that's not a question on the hearings, but I think my position is well known. A disinformation campaign from the Sandinista government is kept the American people from knowing a lot of the truth about that situation down there. And I think the most decent thing this country can do is to continue to aid the freedom fighters.
To the tune of how much? To the tune of how much? 300 million? 105 million?
I can't give you an exact figure.
But you are going to ask for an increase?
I'm going to ask to support the country.
You think that North has helped you on that?
Hey, Alan, we're saving the seat.
How are you going to make your views known?
Stand on the roof and yell.
I'll be there.
There you are. Pointing out that that was you. Right?
We waited on you.
Did you think I was going to sit down and win today?
I had to ask that one.
Good.
I never want to miss a lick at straightening up the situation.
The matter is that testimony will help.
I guess the meeting is underway.
Well, we want to thank you for having given us a responsibility, which from the very beginning was obviously a very great one. And as we got into it further, it appeared it was even more.
Before you go, we should get individual photos of President Gate Show.
Oh my gosh.
That's my
problem.
Thanks, Mr. President. Thank you, Mr. President. Great job.
Thank you, sir.
Have a good
day. It's a pleasure.
I don't know if I've had it deeply.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. President, was it right to fire Oliver North and let Admiral Poindexter just resign?
I am going to be making a statement when all of this hearing is over, and then I will be ready to talk, but I don't think I'm going to make any comment until...
Where does the buck stop, sir? Poindexter said it stopped with him.
I'll make my comments when it's all over.
Are you angry about Admiral Poindexter's not having told you about the version of the Mr. President?
Again, I'm going to save any comments till the whole hearing is
lights, please. Complete.
Right in the
taking us this way, aren't
we? Let's go this way, please.
Mr. President, do you feel that you were deceived by some of your advisors at the time?
No comments, please.
Where's Meese?
Let's go, please, gentlemen.
You guys never stop.
You didn't want to call me out.
There's three or four cabinet members
that are smarter than this.
Well done.
Yeah.
Not a word.
Not a word.
I finally heard from Donaldson.
A couple of weeks ago, I've been traveling, taking a message to the people that we need to redouble our efforts with regard to economic freedoms and fundamental reforms and a balanced budget. One that's the result of reducing wasteful spending rather than raising taxes, I think, is central to what we're trying to accomplish. As we sit here today, I think both houses in the Congress are thinking up 100 or more ways to raise taxes. And they've only got one way to cut spending, and Cap knows all about that. Last week, Jim Miller sent out a memorandum asking each of you to find a additional ways to reduce government costs because of the deterioration in the deficit since I submitted my budget in January of this year. And I've asked Jim to give us a status report on what the situation is and to talk about how to get these additional savings. There you are.
Thank you, Mr. President. If we could look at the piece of paper, the little...